things.
What do you reckon of the curries now? Do you think that in the supermarkets? Because I've seen one of my friends actually get a jar and he kind of spices it up and then he puts the chicken. What do you? I've never ever tried. I've always said to myself I would get one and just try it and just
I've
see.
never tried it, but I mean, a couple of people say, I'll be totally honest, they say they've got a lot better, they're not so bad, they're cheaper, but if you go into a restaurant, you don't get the atmosphere, you don't get that kind of thing. And the breads, they will never match because breads are done on the tandoori oven, which is you can't, you know, they will make the breads
I think
and then
I love the
they
stories about how the restaurants developed. So back then they didn't have a tandoori oven, so they wouldn't have a clay oven. So back then it was, I don't know, someone used to say chicken Maryland, and then you didn't even have a masala, you had chicken curry, put a little bit more spice in it, it's Madras, a bit more, it's Vindaloo, and then the ones you
Well, a
didn't
lot
like,
of
you
it
make
was
a
invented
fowl.
in Britain,
Yeah, but
wasn't
what I'm
it?
saying is they didn't have a clay oven. It's basic cooking. So you would
Yeah.
almost have like the English dishes, you'd have like fried chicken and chips, and then a few people that are adventurous would say, okay, I'll try this chicken curry, and that's how it kind of started.
Yeah.
And then they got a clay oven, and
Well,
now you've got all sorts.
I think in the last 15 years, without a doubt, in the restaurant, we have seen the English palate for spicy just go up.
People don't realize, they just think that the heat is different, isn't it? So obviously you've got green chili heat,
You've
chili
got,
powder
yeah,
heat, and you've got a pickle heat.
you've got
I
pickle
think
heat.
we're just naturally grown up with
Well, I mean,
chilies.
like the British palate now is just amazing. I mean, we see Navy guys coming
I
in.
think
They're
it's,
like foul green
don't you think
chili.
it's amazing when
But
people come
even
over?
James came in on the weekend. He's a guy we delivered to in France, and he was just like, you know, if the French people can't have it hot. And this is the whole reason he has a foul,
Is
and
ridiculous.
it's
It's
ridiculously hot. He
hot.
brought in some like pilots over the
The
weekend
thing
and
is, he
stuff.
doesn't even break a sweat.
He doesn't break a sweat. It's you can tell these people are not showing off. They literally can handle it. But going back, I'm going to say another story, right? So this Chinese, these load of students came in, and a Chinese guy came. Well, he was new to the UK, and he came in. I think they was kind of mingling, and he said, "I want your hottest curry." And I thought some Chinese people can have it really hot. They're kind of either not hot or very hot. I don't really see
It's
them in
because it's such a
between.
big country and it's vast.
Yeah, and so he said, "Look, I want this as hot as you can make it, you know, blah blah blah, as hot as you can do." So I said, "Look, you know, we can do a pho with green chilies and some naga in there. Naga is one of the hottest chilies in the world." He said, "Yeah, I'm not going to be afraid." So I said, "You know, no problem, you know." So I went to the chef and said, "Look, this guy's Chinese. He seems, you know, he seems he's okay. Some people you get try to be macho. And if they are trying to be macho, we're just trying to like kind of say, look, this guy's been macho, don't make it hot. He might, you know, not be able to handle it." So this guy had it. He was sweating. His face went red. We got him water and he was struggling, really struggling. I was like, "I'm really sorry. I really didn't know." You know, like he's like, "Oh, Indian hot in the UK. I didn't realize it's this hot." And I said, "The British guys can have it this hot now, you know." And so he was surprised. I thought he'll never return. He did actually come in the next day, and I said, "Did you want the same again?" And he was like, "Nah, I just have a Jalfrezi." So it was quite a good story. But I mean, he was surprised. He was from China, and he just could not believe the British can have it that hot. And going back to James, you know, when we delivered to France, it was all because he would go into French restaurants and say, "Make it as hot as you can," similar to what this Chinese guy said. And the French just couldn't deliver. They would just make it sort of Madras then. And we know, we've known James for years and years. We know like a Madras isn't going to even tickle him. So,
He probably puts that on his toast in the morning.
yeah, we gave him four chicken fowls actually. And I was telling him when he gave me the food order, I was saying fowl's not on there, but he just took the liberty of putting the four fowls on there. And then he froze three of them. Yeah, but I mean, going back, you know, when I did go into France, you know, we had more. These are all expats, and they all wanted more hot than mild. You know, we gave them choices: hot, medium, mild. And a lot of the most popular one was the Bengal Naga. And I think one of the ladies said, "Look, my mouth's on fire. I'm loving it." You know, so the British palate for hot is crazy. And I had loads left over, and I said, "Look, guys, you know, you can take some home, you know, I'm not going to take these back with me back to UK." And they were like vultures, like came in. Oh, so I hope they don't mind me describing them as vultures. They came in and they just took it and said, "We're going to freeze them." And I think it was so kind of nice to see that the Brits need their curry fix as much as we do. You know, mum and dad need their curry fix, but the Brits need their curry fix now. I think it's become so part of life. And, you know, like, you know, you've been as your mum and dad, they, you know, they'll eat whatever, but they need their curry fix. And now it seems like the British people have really taken to it.
So do you think it's, when you say the curry fix and you say mum and dad need it, do you think it's more the rice or it's the curry? Is it the spice or is it because the rice feels
good? It's the spice.
And you see it in third world countries, don't you, where they're dropping off rice and it's really filling and you feel like when you eat rice, it does the job.
I mean, I think it's the spice and the curry more than rice. I mean, they can make the rice quite easily and stuff. But and we have customers that used to come in like 5-6 times a week.
Malcolm came in on... just the other day, and he was saying that he used to, he's a bit sad, obviously that wasn't too well, but he was saying back then the takeaways were you went in with two plates or two bowls, and then they'd pour the curry in there, and then they'd have a tea cloth and they'd wrap it along, and then they'll just take it back to their house, and that's how they would do a takeaway. They didn't even know that they were really doing a takeaway as such. They just went in and that's it. It was almost like going to your neighbours and getting a casserole or something.